Hello students, myself Mrs. Dimple Kundar from Seth Vidya Mandir English High School CBSE will continue Maths for Standard 6 Lesson 9 Data Handling. Students, we come to the last topic of data handling, that is drawing a bar graph. For this we need a graph book, okay, and to represent the data on the bar graph we need to follow certain things. We need to draw two perpendicular lines, one vertical and one horizontal. I'll show when I do one sum. Along the horizontal line, we'll mark the items, and along the vertical line, the corresponding numbers or values. Then we take the bars of same width, keeping uniform gap between them, and choose a suitable scale to mark the corresponding values. This is the bar graph book which you get, and these are the graphs or the bars on which you draw. So first step, we will draw a vertical and horizontal line. Okay, when I draw, now I have drawn my vertical line, I have drawn my horizontal line. I need the point where it meets, I need to write as 0. I will write, I put an arrow here, and this is called as the y-axis, and I will put an arrow at the end of this. This is called as the x-axis of the bar graph. Let's do the exercise 9.4. A survey of 120 school students was done to find which activity they preferred to their free time. So now the preferred activity: playing, reading storybooks, watching TV, listening to music, and painting. These will be written in my vertical line. And number of students: 45, 30, 20, 10, and 15 will be written in my horizontal line to show the corresponding values. Now draw a bar graph to illustrate the above, taking the scale of 1 unit length is equal to 5 students. So the scale is given. So I will write my scale on the top right hand corner. Scale 1 unit is equal to 5 students. Writing of the scale is very important. Now when I do, I will put the number of students on my vertical line, and the scale I will mark from 0. I will mark, see the graphs, you can see 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, I'll write till 5. Plus on the horizontal line, we need my preferred activity. So I will write here, preferred activities. Okay, now I have to keep a proper width. So according to year, I have to make this thing, write my values. First I will write playing, then leave one gap. I will write reading storybooks. I leave one box again, and then I will write watching TV, leave one box, and I will write listening to music, leave one line, and the last one is painting. Okay, I have to make the boxes with the same width and keeping uniform gap between them. The values, like playing is 45, so I will make a mark of it at the place for playing. I will make a mark of 45. Then reading storybooks is 30, so I will put a mark on 30. I'll put the marks first and I will draw the bar later on, graphs later on. Watching TV is 20, so corresponding value of TV will be at 20. And listening to music is 10, so I will see the corresponding value and put a mark at 10. Please use a scale and pencil. And painting is 15, so I will mark here as 15. And now I will draw the vertical lines for the bars. Here, now my bar graph is ready. Playing, now you can read the graph. Playing, how many students? 45. See, it is related to 45. Reading storybooks, it is coming up to, see, the corresponding value is 30. Okay. Watching TV, the corresponding value is 20. Yes, and the listening to music, the corresponding value is 10. And painting, the corresponding value is 15. And see the difference in the graph, the spacing is done perfectly. And this is the way you make your graph. Okay. There is one more question which is given here. Which activity is preferred by most of the students other than playing? So now looking at the graph, or looking at the numbers, you can see now maximum value is 45. Now which other activity, now when I look at the graph, my next activity which students like more is, yes, reading story books. So I can write the answer here. Reading story books. Okay, so is it easy? You all have understood?